And that is, everything around you that you call life was made up by people that were no smarter than you. And you can change it. You can influence it. You can build your own things that other people can use.
Hi, welcome to my video, Access Control List. The purpose of an Access Control List is to make a router more efficient at protecting your network, even though it is not a dedicated security device. An access control list can make your router very effective at protecting the network. Filtering inbound traffic, inbound and outbound traffic, is probably one of the main things that it does. When set up correctly, you can prevent spoofing and even alleviate and prevent distributed denial of service attacks. Now, it is recommended that you put the access list on your border routers with an access list for your inbound traffic and an access list for your outbound traffic. Now let's talk about some of the major duties of an ACL access control list. As I sort of mentioned earlier, probably the number one duty is to filter packets inbound and outbound so you control traffic with access control lists. Now you can block based on source IP address or destination IP address. Source IP address is probably a standard ACL, where destination is extended ACL. You can block traffic based on type of traffic, the protocol being used, even the interface being used. Telnet SSH is probably a common blocking technique. Now, another use for ACL is to increase performance by not loading down your router with routing table updates. Now, you, the administrator, can use access control lists to prioritize traffic based on what kind of data it is. Really, you're in control and you have granular control of how data is prioritized across your network. Now, let's say you have a slow link on your network. Well, you can use ACLs to limit the amount of traffic that goes through that link. This way you maintain performance throughout your network. Speed, performance, as well as confidentiality, integrity, and accessibility. That's what everybody wants. And I guess it's what technology provides. Now, when giving your access list a name, give it a good name. This way you can identify it easily and quickly in an event of a network outage and get the network back up and running as quickly as humanly possible. Now, ACLs do not begin doing their thing until they are activated. Remember, you want one for your inbound and you want a separate one for your outbound traffic. Welcome to my standard access list video. And kind of like subnetting, the key to success when working with access lists or learning about access lists is to actually practice. Set up a home lab, set up GNS3, and type them up. There's also a packet tracer from Cisco. The point is practice. Pick up scenarios from the web. Pick up books, look up scenarios, and practice the scenarios. Standard access lists 0 through 99, which is plenty. I want to warn you about the invisible blanket that is implicit deny. Whenever you make an entry to an access list, there's always this implicit deny. It covers everything. Now, quickly, wildcard bits is an expression that says, hey, look at me. The iOS command for access list is access list, and to erase an access list, you type in no access list, but you gotta be careful because you basically shut down the port when you do that. Now, access list can seem confusing at first, especially with the implicit deny, but with practice, you get comfortable. Now, like with any technology, Cisco, it has its advantages and its pitfalls, so you have to configure it correctly to be successful. Again, the wildcard mask is an expression that says, look at me. The rule of thumb is replace all zeros with 255s and all 255s with zeros. This is a rule of thumb when working with wildcard mask, also known as inverse masks. Now when it comes to standard access lists, you're mostly going to be dealing with inbound traffic. Also, when you're dealing with standard access lists, you want to place the access list closest to your destination as a rule of thumb. I was mentioning earlier, be careful when you delete an access list because the port can be affected. All communication on the port will be affected. Now, access lists do not take effect until they are applied. Now, your standard access control list is a top to bottom list that basically dictates what traffic is allowed in and out. It can be very granular. Some old timers say they're better than firewalls. Well, that's my video. Thanks for watching.